P-P-P-Lo, time to bring the bass back. Sir, I'm going big like a lineman. She want bring the limes in. She wanna pull up to the crib, we can't dine in. Up right away, couldn't even get a vine in. Straight with the money, we aligned in. Tell me how they broke, tryna chime in. Jesus watching over here in diamonds. He the only reason why do not get violent. Ay, cause he gave me patience. Ay, swear to all makes sense. Ay, when you making bands, can make friends.
Coach, thank you much. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Tennessee Titans and our home team. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. This will be taken in at the one. Throw on first down with Stidham. Steps away to his left. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Hey, team six, team six.
To throw is Stidham, and incomplete. James Washington was the intended target, and it's third and five.
There are a good number of coaches at any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver, and on that play, it was batted down.
On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Pretty woeful there, just 23 yards on the punt. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. Chargers in good field position to start out, first and 10. Play action, it's Trubisky. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way, lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
Throwing again on second down. Trubisky and caught by Henry. And he'll take this from 147-yard line to the other. A gain of 6. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Got an extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for third down. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And it's complete. Henry. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A gain of 22.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage and mixed traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Third and two. Now Trubisky. And this is complete. It's Allen. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen, his fourth touchdown on the year. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. The PAT up and good, but hold on a second. There is a flag.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt, they're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Look at me. Go. You got time. You got time.
Second down, Stidham to throw. Flushed out right. And that is incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. On third down, Stidham. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
I think the punter might start to get into a pretty good rhythm here if he keeps getting opportunities. But that's the last thing his team wants to have happen, right? The last thing you want to see is your punter feeling pretty good because he's out there all the time.
Yeah, first quarter only, but they're 0 for 2 on third down conversions to start this thing. 37 yards on the punt with no return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Charger drive about to get going. And coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time out. Now they have the football back. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice. It all came together. But I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room and pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
Open man, here's Foster. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
On second down now, it's Welch. Tackle made by Kenny Vaccaro.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
A good chance this is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. From the shotgun is Trubisky. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
Yeah. Hey.
Come on, ready?
Crunch down, defense.
Now Gordon on first down. And he's got... There goes Melvin Gordon. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Melvin Gordon, his sixth touchdown of the season. The Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. Here's Badgley now to try to add the PAT. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all, and let's face it. Every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum? At
the
20-yard line.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8.
Double tight, guys. Double tight.
You got three down.
On second down, here's Stidham. They will find Davis. That's complete. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Let's go! 90s Wolf! General West!
You must be getting tired of seeing me!
Let's go!
Stidham. And this is caught! A spectacular one-handed grab there. Good contain. No gain on the screen, and it'll bring up fourth down.
No gain on the play. It's now fourth down.
Here's Brett Kern now, as he's on to punt for Tennessee. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Here's Brett Kern now, as he's on to punt for Tennessee. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. On the return, Jackson. They'll get 9 yards on the return there following a punt of 42. And out will come the offense as they take over. On the NFL scoreboard, an update from Los Angeles. It's the Rams that have grabbed the early lead. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. The Charger drive about to get going. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, they could really put them in command before intermission.
Yeah, and it's all well and good what they're seeing and how they're feeling right now. But it's the NFL. How many times have we watched 14-0 leads evaporate and quickly? So how have we seen them combat it? Continue to run your offense, but don't back off at all. Don't start looking at the clock. Don't start thinking about, hey, just take care of the football. Keep attacking. Usually the best way to maintain control.
Trubisky now off the bootleg. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
Well, there's times when you see these catches that are made, and we just know the guys playing it are really wishing for college rules. Only need that one foot down instead of two. It's awfully difficult on the sideline, isn't it?
On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 11 yards there, first down. So following the run by Gordon, here's first and 10. And they give this time to the tailback. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Here's Trubisky to throw. And that is incomplete. Keenan Allen, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Sets up the screen to Gordon. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a 1st down.
They're not ready for this, man. They're not ready for this. They still playing, man.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. Nothing on 1st down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, 2nd and goal. On 2nd and goal, they'll give it to him again. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's 3rd and goal.
It's now 3rd and goal.
And he's going to have the connection to Foster. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Robert Foster, his 2nd touchdown on the season. For the Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And it's now 21-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3 and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the 1st half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back.
Now Stidham on 2nd down. He gets it to Humphreys. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A gain of 13. It's a 1st down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
At the 36-yard line.
Set 8-3. Hey, Wahoo!
Full strength. 58, right over there, right over there. Yeah, yeah. Mike, 58, right there. Here we go.
Get it.
Stidham will throw again. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new-school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Stidham to throw, and that is incomplete.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Charger drive about to get going. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
Now, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? Where everything is working for them, every move they make works, it clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
Now Gordon. It's a first down and more for Gordon. He's at the 40. Past the 20. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Melvin Gordon with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. For the Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And a rout is on here in this first half. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Typically down in the first half, I might say, oh, you at least need a field goal out of this drive, but they're down to the point where they need a touchdown, don't they?
Yeah, normally you know me. I mean, you've been around me for a while now, right?
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry about that. But normally I'm the one preaching patience. Yeah. You know, take your time, first half, you still got a chance. I think they're out of patience here. This has to be a drive that gets a touchdown. So if you're the play caller, you're going to that portion of the sheet that says big-time plays, specials, anything you can use to get yourself back into it.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down.
Here we go. Squeeze.
Let's go. Let's bring it. Let's bring it.
Watch the safety crease. Now.
Stidham, third down from the gun. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. Here's Brett Kern now, as he's on for the 5th time here today. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. It's just a 30-yard punt that time, no return. The Charger drive about to get going. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just given them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because The way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Here's Trubisky. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
All right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player? Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
The Chargers on third down. No problems to this point. A perfect 5 for 5. This will be third and six. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. He punted 5 times in the win last week as this one's away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film. Extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that, and thus far they've been successful.
Now it's Stidham. On the screen, this is Cannon. And he's going to be taken down about a yard shy of the first at the 29. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. The Charger drive about to get going. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
2nd and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now Trubisky to throw. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock. Johnson, the intended target. Third down here.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
17 yards for the Chargers there as they got themselves a first down. They go back to Gordon here on first down. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. And we're going to get a timeout. With 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Now the second-year kicker, Michael Badgley. He hit from 59 as a rookie. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So we've reached halftime here in Carson with the Chargers on top. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. This is fielded at the goal line. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spend the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. They'll keep it on the ground. This time it's Gordon. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
Check, 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 check. Back, back, back.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28. It's a 7-yard run, but it does bring up fourth down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
Let's go, D.
Now Lewis here on first down. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down deep into Charger territory. It's a big play there by Lewis. 43 yards on the ground.
And the Titans first down.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry. He will push his way down to about the 14. 2 yards that time, a stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Rip left, rip left.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Gets it to his running back, Cannon. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Trenton Cannon, his second touchdown on the season. And the Titans are able to cut into that deficit. Extra point up and good by Succop. And that will get him one closer. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. And they're coming off a 3 and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't caught.
Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. The 305-pound defensive end, Jarrell Casey, gets the sack.
Like how they've started the third quarter here. They force a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Throwing here, Trubisky. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. It's a gain of 5, but it'll lead to a fourth down.
Well, they got off the field on third down. An excellent job, an excellent defensive series. We always talk about adjustments, and usually only at halftime. But the best teams adjust series to series. And on that series, they adjusted so well that they got the job done in fine style.
Penalty stings big time there, wipes away a very good return.
And they work on it so hard because the goal is to give yourself some space for your offense to really work, try and gain an additional first down outside the 20 or 25-yard line. Instead, this one's going to come back.
So the special teams penalty costs some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and 1.
Anytime the offense shows what they call a shot play or a chunk play where they're trying to get big yardage, sometimes people just call it gadget plays, and you hold it to a gain that we just saw there, you feel pretty good about yourself as a defense.
Now Stidham. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And he'll get this down only to the 18. Justin Jones there on the stop.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
Here's Stidham. They set up the screen for Henry. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Give him 5 on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
From the gun, it's Stidham. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Trevor Williams with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Hey, 18.
After the interception, here's Trubisky. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Lock in. 61, Matchbox
White. Second and 10 now. It's Trubisky. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
All right, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. Third and long coming up. Back near your own goal line. I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for them. You got to try and find some space for your punter because you don't want it backed up where he has to alter what he does.
And they'll rally and stop him short of the first down at about the six. Call it a gain of five. Fourth down now. Here's Michael Pilardi now as he's on to punt for L.A. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Jerry Tillery, he's the one to get him. And that is sack number seven for him on the year. Stidham, he's going to launch it for Washington. And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down, but to no avail as time will expire on this third quarter of play. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Stidham, off play action. And the throw there going to be incomplete. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
Here's Brett Kern now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Here's Jackson to return. A 41-yard punt, nine on the return. The Charger drive about to get going. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
6-6, pull it high. Hey, alert, 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 alert.
Throwing on second down, Trubisky forced out to his left, and he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. The improv act there, good for nine, and now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and one.
Partner, he was going through his progressions, not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it, and he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
They'll try and run it. Here's Gordon. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. They run it here with Gordon. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Tackle that time by Jerome Baker out of Ohio State.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they won't put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Now a give right side. Welch, he's got the first down and more inside the 40. And down to the 16-yard line. And he will finally be taken down at the Titans' 16-yard line.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Open man here is Foster. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Three touchdown passes now for Mitchell Trubisky as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But Sunday, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
From the 26, they'll line up on second and 4. Now it's Stidham. Complete. This is Lewis. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 6 yards, the pickup, and that's a first down.
On the ready.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
No, check that. We got Mike 52 right here. Mike 52.
On first and 10, it's Stidham. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking to find some space for Deion Lewis there. That'll bring up second down. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
And good pursuit yet again by the Chargers as they stuff him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd-and-11 situation. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Whip. Watch the whip. 52's the mic. Watch Mike. Get in the weight room.
Hey, Charlie.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he'll find Washington. That's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 16 yards there, a Tennessee first down. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Stidham dancing to his left. It's caught. Humphreys. 27 yards there. A first down. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Tackle made there by the safety, Derwin James. It's rare that a man his size can't at least push forward for a yard, but they stopped him there for nothing.
You're talking about tiny? You talking about the little guy back there? That monster. Yeah, you're exactly right. And it takes a group effort to get a guy like that down and not let him find some space. The first guy in, he's got to take one for the team, right? Because he's just waiting there.
And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
Extra point put through by Succop, and that will shave one more off this lead. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Let's go.
The Charger drive about to get going. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
It's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
Looky here, Trubisky wants to throw it. Now Trubisky lost the football. So plenty of smiles for the folks here as they head for the exits. It's a victory for their hometown guys. And when you break it down, you know, this was just a thoroughly dominating performance.
And I truly thought that we'd have a tight game coming into this one. I think you felt the same way based on our conversation after the production meeting. But obviously not the case. And how about just how it broke open? You know, you just all of a sudden, whoosh, there it is. This thing is pretty much done. And the crowd stayed with it to celebrate because they're like,